What's up again, everybody? This is going to be the last pre-recorded video I'm going to make. This knife is not mine. This knife belongs to my fiance. Now, what makes this knife special is it's made of copper. At least the handle is. So this is a otter messer, as you can see already. Now, this is a otter messer. Otter messer owns the company Mercator, which is right here. And this was a really popular knife. There's a lot of these made with a steel handle that is painted black with a cat here with, like, I think it's K55 backwards K. A lot of people call it the black cat knife. There's a video, I'm going to link to it in the description, to a knife guy in Germany who did a awesome historical background on this style knife. So I advise you to go over there and check it out. It's really decent. The production value is high. So let's get on with this knife. What makes this one different is that this one is copper. My girlfriend likes this knife because she is a fanatic of rose gold. And if you know anything about rose gold, it is gold mixed with copper. So it's gold with like a reddish color to it. So she loved this. Now, what also makes this cool and special, and yes, I know it's not a slip joint. Okay, so chill. Don't. Give me 50,000 comments below.
It's not a slip joint. You're a slip joint guy. It's not a slip.
I know. Chill. We're going to talk about some different knives sometimes. This is a traditional pocket knife, okay? Doesn't always have to be a slip joint. Anyway, what makes this one, end of rant, sorry. What makes this one special is has a cool pocket clip. How cool is that? Now, my girlfriend doesn't know that I just picked this thing up. Okay, and I'm going to make a video with it. So I haven't opened this blade yet. Let's see how a woman treats their knives. Are you ready for this? Do you think it'll be clean, or do you think it'll be like gooky with plastic tape stuck on it from opening up all those packages of things that they order that they don't need? Let's find out. Hey, it's relatively clean. Wow. Relatively. My girlfriend is a good knife caretaker. How nice. She probably doesn't watch this video, so who cares what I say about her? But anyway, I'm just joking. I know you're watching this. Don't hit me. All right. Mercator stainless steel knife. This is a, I think it's a 4-inch blade, might be 3.5, made in Germany, solid in Germany, of course. And, you know, otter. I like the logo. It's not the traditional black cat logo. But it is also Lockback. So locked. Unlocked. Very cool. It has a very prominent sound when it locks. This pocket clip is very nice. Very nice. And a lanyard loop as well. So what makes this knife kind of neat is that it's not really expensive to manufacture. This is a piece of, you know, metal, steel or copper in this case. And it's flat. They stamp it out. Then they crease it in a machine that curves it. And then you just assemble, put the knife in there, and you rivet the thing in there. It's very quick and easy to manufacture. These knives were popular in World War I by German soldiers. I watched that video, link in description, to the guy who did a nice review on this style knife, and that they called these the Kaiser knife, or Kaiser Wilhelm knife. So that's about that. Let's get a measurement on the blade. I think it's, let's see, is it 4 inches? No, it's about 3.5? You want to call it 3.5? Well, the blade parts, but the knife itself is about 3.5. The blade ends at 3.25. The handle is 4.5. Nope, that's about 4.25 as well, right there. 4.25 closed length. Closed length, I don't know if you should count the lanyard loop, so I'm not going to. Closed, we're looking at, yes. I was wondering if it would protrude. It does not, so it's still be 4.25. So, but I just, let's get some close-ups. This this copper is very cool. They do make one in brass, that's right. They make it brass, copper, and steel. I think they have like a chrome-lined one, and not chrome-lined, but chrome-plated, and so on. They, I think they make them in carbon. They have them in black painted. I think I just said that. I'm not sure. But the best way to what I compare these things to are those Duke knives, but of higher quality. Okay, I think these are significantly higher quality than the Duke, which I apparently was miscall mis saying the name as Doke in a previous video. Forgive me, I am not perfect. So I think it's cool. I love how it says Mercator, Germany on it, on the back of the spine of this knife, because that just screams quality to me. The stainless steel clip, the rivets are all very nice and just nice. Look at that. I don't think you could ever find one of these that are bad because they're pretty simple to make. Stainless steel blade, very nice. I have an affiliate link in the description to these knives from Amazon. You can buy them there. And another good reason to buy something like this from Amazon is that if you get a bad one, you can return it, exchange it for another one, or just return it if you don't like it. So that's kind of nice. But yeah, I have affiliate link for several different styles of this knife down below. Check them out. It helps support the channel. Also, like and subscribe if you haven't already. So this is it. This is it. I love the stamping of that otter, the otter messer. Just cool. She loves it. I like it. I actually plan on getting the black cat one because I kind of feel like my collection needs that one. So very cool. It's nice in the hand, you can see. Fills the hand very well. I think they make a smaller one of this as well. They make them in several different sizes. And this is a very, you know, it makes a great utility knife, really. You know, you could just kind of keep in your pocket. It's made of steel. You don't really have to worry about scratching it up or tearing it up or cracking the bone. That's kind of it. You just use it and abuse this thing. So, guys, that's it. I think this is the last video before I'm going to be making them current. This is pre-recorded video, pre-surgery. All right, guys, I'll see you next week with a new video.